Hi, this is Richard Gilewitz, and I was just recently at the Music Mesa show in Frankfurt, Germany, and there's always new players there and new products, and sometimes it gets a little bit cloudy, I'll say that. And one particular booth and company that got my attention was AddString. They're based, I believe, in Holland, and basically there's only three parts to their little device. One is this tuner by the headstock. You just clip this on. I'll hold it up there so you can see that. And just a little simple tuner that clips on. And then you have this half moon shaped piece here with a little button hook on it. And that's to hide the string if you're in the middle of playing and you want to tuck it back in there and then release it so you can add it or release it. And surprisingly, this button hook, when I put it under there and then release it, I thought maybe it would stretch it out of tune, but fortunately it didn't. So I'll show you this little half moon piece right there. You can see that. And then the third part is this little end piece here, and that's where you choose where you want to add the string. So for example, at the show, they had a third string octave, which was the G string, and they had the octave string right on top of that, similarly to a 12 string. The neat thing about this is you could have elected to put that string below the third string and have the octave down there. The same thing with string four. So what I did is I happen to have a fourth string octave. I just added it there, and you can see, I'll hold that up there so you can see the little end piece with the button hook. And the thing is, you'll notice that there's pins here, and there are some bridgeless pins these days, and they have another piece in addition to this that comes with it that you can put in the end here, and so you can accommodate the pinless bridges as well. So let me just give you an example here, and this has it in place right there. So if I'm just strumming some chords, then if in the middle of the tune I want to hook that button in there, you get a six string effect. If you were strumming. Now let's say if I wanted to maybe put a capo on, let's say I'll put a capo on maybe the fourth fret here, line that up, and the same thing. It didn't put it out of tune. Great capo, by the way, Shub. So you've got, then if I want to tuck it back in, it's down there. Release it. The finger pick, you can see just like with a 12 string, as I come down with my thumb, normally when I play a 12 string, I design my right hand patterns so they may intentionally target a third or fourth string octave. So I'm able to do that here. You get kind of a chorus type effect, or a little bit of a 12 string effect. I'm not honestly sure if it's coming out through the video, but I can tell you when you're playing it here, or if you're in the room, or if, especially if you plug it in, you can tell a remarkable difference. And like I said, I like the freedom of being able to select the string it goes next to as an octave string. I believe you can also use a unison for say two or one. And it's a cool little toy. It's worth checking out for sure for all you guitar aficionados out there. So good luck to you.